Hello. Hey guys, sorry for not being able to take up the class for the morning. Actually, what happened was last night I came very, very late from office, you know, due to the project. It is a Canada client, so we had some discussions based on their office time. So, by the time I came home, it was around 12:30, 1 o'clock. So I couldn't get up early. Sorry. Just now I came, I was trying to, as usual, I was working out the scenarios prehand so that by the time I take class for you people, it should not be, there must not be surprises or shocks. Okay, so, just now I tried the third party sales as well as the intercompany sales and it was really working. So I thought, okay, let me record them first, okay, because in case, I don't know why it failed that day, day before yesterday. And if anything happens tomorrow, I don't want the tomorrow also to get wasted. So I am recording this third party scenario as well as the intercompany sales. You go through that. Anyway, like you will see that we will discuss that in the class. Okay. If you have any doubts, you can always ask. So first is the third party scenario. What is a third party scenario? We had discussed there are certain things like, this happens normally in the trading industry. What happens is like, you buy goods from your vendor and you add up your margin and then you are selling to your customer. Sometimes like it happens like you are running out of the stock. By the time your customer asks for a consignment, he says like, I want it urgently. If in case of a normal scenario or leisure, what you can do, you can order some more goods from your vendor, you take it into your stock, into your inventory, okay, then you can deliver it to your customer. But in this case, it happens like you might want to avoid the delays by you involving in the deliveries. And also there is a cost involved whenever there is goods handling from our side. Of course, there is a cost involved, like we have to pay the delivery cost to our vendor. We have to pay for our resources, men, money, machine. We have to engage the machines to handle the goods, unload it in our place. Okay. Then we have to load it, create delivery, load it into the customer's thing. Okay. So to avoid these things, we may go for a third party scenario. And other thing is like, there are some goods which are not fast moving or sometimes like you could say those are special goods. So as a principle, you don't want to stock those materials because you never know when the order for those materials come. Okay. In such cases, if somebody orders that material, then you can always ask your vendor to supply to the customer directly. This is the third party scenario. In terms of configuration, okay, there is not much involved. To be really frank, there is not much involved. Except the item category. That way we showed like, we normally use the item category norm for our standard goods. Okay. If an item or article is habitually a third party item, which means like, just now we have said like, as a principle you don't say that stock that material in your house. So, whenever you get the order, then only you will go get back to the vendor saying that I have received an order for so and so much. Okay. So, if an article is a habitually third-party item, then it makes sense to maintain the item category group as BANS, branch, instead of our normal NORM norm. If you store it as branch, if you go to the item category determination, you can find the system determining the third party item as TAS. Okay. So much of the control lies with the item category as usual. Okay. So let us go to the sales document item, okay, item category. So let us see what parameters differentiate TAS from the other standard item category TAM. Okay, so let me choose TAS. Okay. This is a third party item. You can see the description itself. Okay. See, it is relevant for billing. See, it is almost like a normal one. So it is allowed for billing, it is allowed for pricing, okay. So when you say that it is allowed for billing, it is neither delivery related nor, okay, it is order related billing, because you are not handling the goods by yourself. Means you are going to write an invoice for the against the customer for the quantity he had ordered. Okay. Of course, there could be some difference in the quantity actually ordered and the quantity delivered by the vendor. In such cases, you can always overwrite that quantity with the in sales order with the received quantity. Okay, so this is a order related billing. And other than that, it is okay. Everything you can allow the schedule length, its weight and volume allowance. It's a credit active one to determine the costs and other things. And if you come to the determination rule, I told you that this article is maintained the item category as BANS. So if you remember what is the item category determination, I could say like document type plus item category group is BANS. It's not our norm. Okay. I don't have usage or I don't have the higher level item category. Then the system determines the BAS. Okay. This is one scenario. Sometimes if it happens that you don't use the item as a third party item regularly, it means when you are running out of stock, then you will be handling that material as a third party item. So I am letting the system to determine the TAN as usual, but I am giving the choice as TAS as the alternate material. So instead of TAP, TAQ, where is that? I can allow the system to overwrite the item category as the man giving another option as TAS. So let me save it. Okay, fine. I believe you all know where to set the item category. It is in the sales organization 2 view of the material master. Okay. So now let us see that in the action. So now I am going to create a sales order. Okay. It's a normal order. Okay. It's my regular customer. Okay. Third party sales. Okay. Let me enter a article T-8101. Let me put it as a huge quantity. Okay, let me say 500 pieces or even it could be more than that. Okay, so that should be fine. Okay. Going by the normal item category determination rule, we could see the system determining TAN. Okay. If the system is determining TAN, let me show what happens in the schedule line item. Okay, first thing is the schedule and category is determined as CP, and we have only three options, that is sales, shipping and procurement. Okay, take a look at this thing. I have an assignment for you at this moment. Okay, I want you to note down this schedule and category, that is CP, and go to the schedule and category categories property in the SPRO and see what are all the parameters for CP. Just now I told like, okay, this 101 is not a habitually third party item for me. Okay, so I didn't maintain it as bands, instead I maintained as norm. So the system determines the item category as TAN. Okay. Now I am overwriting as the item category TAS. You could see that this business transaction type has been predetermined. Okay. Now I select that line, I go to schedule lines. I could see some changes. Can you see that? You have an additional button called as process requisition. Okay. If I click the process requisition, I can see what are all the values that are going to be used in this process requisition. Okay. And if here I have assigned the vendor for this material, that is 1000, and there is info record. Just like how we have our customer material info record, the MM people have their own vendor info record, purchasing info record. Okay. So they have this purchasing info record and everything is filled here. Okay. So here they have told what is going to be the purchasing price for this. So now, okay, the your assignment is there. Okay. Previously I had told you to note down what are the parameters for scheduling category CP. Okay. Okay. Now you can see that system has determined the new schedule length category, that is CS. Okay. Now I want you to look into the CP and CS and find out, okay, what is the difference. Okay. I come back. Okay, like I want to show you the schedule line also. Okay, in the schedule line, you have entered a large quantity. Okay, still the system confirms whatever you asked for your required delivery, because here the system is not going to carry out any availability check in the plant. Okay, in fact, because it is going to be done by your vendor, so there is no availability check. The system confirms the quantity whatever you have required delivery date for. Come back, let me save the change order. Change order 11880 has been saved. So I want to, let me go into the change order by either change mode or display mode. 11880. I select that line, go to the schedule line. I could see the system has generated a process requisition. We always have discussed the difference between a purchase requisition and a purchase order, which means purchase requisitions are always a wish list. Okay, they will be converted into purchase orders by the merchandiser or buyer by adding the quantity, adding or modifying the quantities, or sometimes even adding or modifying the item itself. Okay. So let me note down the purchase requisition. Okay. Now I have to. Okay, now this scenario shifts from sales to merchandiser. Let me say right now, I am a merchandiser or a buyer sitting in the central office or central distribution center. Transaction ME21N. Okay, and ME21N is the transaction code to create purchase orders. Okay. I mean, like, if you are comfortable, I mean, it took almost a year for me to get familiarized with this cycle, this purchasing cycle, because this is not our regular thing. I mean, like, if you are comfortable, well and good. If you not, if you are not so comfortable with the following steps, I mean, that are happening in the purchasing side, don't bother about that, okay, because that is being going to be carried out by the purchasing people. So I click the document overview on here. I can see the branches, selection variants. Okay. If I know the purchase requisition number, I can enter it, else I can give the my purchase requisition, which will give the list of purchase requisition which I have created in under my username. Okay, so I select the purchase requisition, I drag it to the shopping cart. It's as easy. So, I mean, like in the sales order, if you went into the purchase requisition button, you can, if you have maintained the vendor purchase info records and everything, then it is easy for you, because the system takes everything from that. See, it has automatically populated the vendor, it has automatically taken the organizational data and everything. If you hadn't maintained the vendor or process info record there, then here you have to enter those missing values manually. Okay. So click the item overview. Okay. So now you could see that your process order is going to be raised with the processing price in the vendor. It will say the plant which is going to be delivered. Obviously, since we are buying, the delivery plant must be ours. However, if you go to the delivery address, you can see the delivery address is for not your plant. It is the address of the customer. So that's it. So let me check for any messages. Click the check. Okay, no messages. So I am raising a purchase order. Okay. What happens after purchasing order? It is okay, like out of SAP system. Okay. I will be sending this purchase order to my vendor. The vendor receives this purchase order. Okay, he says, okay, let me arrange for it. Okay, now we have created the standard purchase order under the sponsor number. Okay, so we have created the purchase order number 45000 17093. Okay. Now whatever happens, it happens out of SAP. It means like my vendor will receive this PO. Okay, he will arrange for the delivery. Then the goods reach the customer's place. Okay. Now the customer will call you and say, okay, I have received so and so goods. Okay. Meanwhile, since we had said that our third party items are relevant for order related billing, it means you need not, I mean you are not going to bill for delivery. It's here because here the delivery itself is not here. That doesn't mean like okay, let us now try to create a billing with reference to the our sales order. Okay. Meanwhile, let me note down the let me note down the purchase order number 4512317096. Okay. So let me try to create a billing for the sales order. Slash in ES01. Okay. You could see the system has taken this number. Okay. This is 3 /EA02 11880. Okay, so let me create a billing for that /NVS01 let me come out of this again. Let me try to bill it. So what happens? It is not generating any billing document. I go to log. I could see the item is not around for billing. This is because the scenario goes like you cannot bill your customer until unless one you receive a confirmation from your customer saying that you have your vendor have sent to your customer or the customer have received so and so quantity of goods. And second thing is like you must check with your vendor first before getting payment from your customer. Okay. Of course, sometimes we say like I maintain different terms of payment with my vendor. That could not be like some in those cases like you can have a statistical income, I mean say outgoing payment for vendor. Something that will be normally handled by the finance people. Okay. So let me carry out a invoice posting for the vendor. The transaction code is MIRO, MIRO. So I am saying today 2011. Okay. And here I am entering the purchase order number. Okay. So what is my purchase order number? 4500 17093. Okay. Let me enter that number. Press enter. Okay. What is my overall cost? God, it's so many huge money. Okay. I'm entering that value here. 137,500 euros. Okay. When I press it, you could see the balance amount becomes zero and has a green icon. Okay, then only it can be posted. So let me post it now. It is giving error saying that I haven't entered the tax code. Okay. It's not a problem because I have change the account so that it can be posted without tax also. And then ask for me like last week when I was checking for that I was stuck in that portion, that part also. So now it has been fine, like you can post it without any problem. Okay. So now we have made a payment to our vendor. So now I am going to write an invoice against my customer for the goods he has received. Slash in ES01, SS1 and SS. Now the system gets into invoicing mode without any problem. Okay. I'll save it. Okay. The document has been saved. So this is the third party scenario. If you remember, I mean like if you just recall the cycle what we had done, all we did was we created a purchase order, I mean sorry, sales order. The sales order automatically generated a purchase requisition. Then the materials management card, your merchandise, he converts the your purchase request into purchase order. The purchase order is sent to the vendor. The vendor sends the goods directly to the customer. your customer confirms you that he has achieved so and so good. Okay. Then after the confirmation, you write a vendor payment payment for your vendor saying that let me pay you for the good what you have sent. Then after settling for your vendor, you are writing an invoice against your customer for the goods he has received from your customer. If you see, I mean, if you have noted the number, the numbers are like for the purchase order, the conditions are the pricing were different, whereas for your sales order, the pricing was again different. This is the third party sales order. Okay. I mean, like this will not be easy for you, and you see because there is no configuration in this case, except the item category determination. Other than that, there is no configuration. Now let us move to the another scenario. Okay, this is called as intercompany case. I believe Abhis was looking forward to this scenario for a long time here. Because I remember I was saying that intercompany claims intercompany case. So let us go to intercompany case. Okay. What is intercompany case before that? So let me say. Okay. Suppose we belong, we have a group of companies. Let me say, I have a group of companies, or I have a company. Let me say, I operate under company code 1000. Let Abhis operate under the company code 2000. Okay. Then we have a common plant. Not common plant, okay. Abhis has a plant. Okay. And as usual, I also will be having my own delivering plant. But because of our business nature, I and Abhis will be handling the same set of goods. Okay, he is also handling the same hard disk, and I am also handling the same hard disk. Okay. And we have an understanding. Okay. And okay, Abhis has a different company code. I believe I can say that. Okay, Abhis is a different company code, and I have a different company code. Okay. One day somebody places an order on me. But I don't have enough goods of that particular stock. Okay. So I am saying, okay, Abhis has a plant, delivery plant. Okay. So I am assigning that plant to the combination of my distribution, my sales organization and distribution channel. Okay. So that I can use that plant for my delivery. Okay. So what happens is somebody places an order with me. And I am unable to deliver that quantity because I am running short of quantity. Okay. Then I will ask Abhis, like I have got an order, I don't have sufficient quantity. Shall I take it from your plant? Okay. Abhis generously says, okay, how can I say no to you? Carry on. So what I do, when I make the sales order, okay, Abhis was gracious enough to give me the good, okay, but that doesn't mean I have to make him the delivery person. Okay. So what happens? I create a sales order. In the sales order, I override the delivering plant with the Abhis plant. Okay. Then as usual, I create deliveries, picking, tracking. Okay. I think in this case there won't be any picking because it is coming from other plant. So you carry out the delivery activities, do the PGA to the customer. Okay. Now you, once the customer confirms that he or she has received so and so good, you are writing an invoice to your customer. Here, you will carry out, here also it is going to be the, it's going to be order based or delivery based. Okay, it is going to be the delivery based. But the system will allow you to create two invoices for the same delivery. It means the moment you write an invoice, one is like you write invoice against your against your customer, and when you run an invoice for the same delivery again, the system makes you as a payer, okay, and writes an invoice against you for Abhis. Okay. So which means like when a run a billing document transaction, VS015. First time I will be raising an invoice against my customer. When I run the invoice again, second time for the same time, the system will raise an invoice against me so that I can pay to a bill. Okay. Here in this process, we have a condition type called as PI01. How PR00 is for our normal or regular sales process, okay. PA01 is for intercompany sales. Okay. So here we have a set of configurations to make. Okay. One, the first most important configuration is that the delivering plans must be assigned to, which means the Abid delivery plant must be assigned to the combination of my sales organization and distribution channel. Okay. That is the first one. And second thing is like the material must be, even though the material I am using, the material must be extended to the Abid plant. Okay, which means you have to maintain the use of sales general plant data and your warehouse management things, okay. That has to be maintained for both the plants, that is my plant as well as the Abin's plant. Okay. And third one, obviously, there must be enough stock available of this material in the delivering plant. Okay. So these are all the three important main steps. And fourth one is like, okay, I talked about the billing part right now. So when I write the invoice first against my customer, okay, the system makes me as a seller and I write the invoice against the payer of my customer. Okay. And when you run the billing again second time, I am made the payer and Abid is made as the customer or the seller who is going to be receiving the payment. Okay. Which means I have to be a payer role here, which means my sales organization must be created as a dummy customer in the sales area of Abid. Obviously, like as if I am a customer, I have to be created for some sales area against whom I am carrying the I am having the transaction. So Abid is going to be the sales area, okay, and I am going to be the customer created in the Abid sales area. These are the major configurations, and even if you falter in any one of the configurations, like we will be having the problem. Of course, like this involves the integration between the finance and other things. Okay. So that could be some COPA settings. Okay, I told you yesterday that I am getting some derivation rule with you, for which I need the help of COPA people, but I didn't get any help as of now. Okay. Still, some derivation rule I try to make my own changes, and I was able to bypass that derivation rule setting. Okay. So let us go into the scenario. So first is, how many windows are open? Okay, SCRO. Fine. The materials, the plant I am going to use, my plant is 1200, that belongs to the company store 1000, whereas the material I am going to take it from, but I mean like in our scenario it is going to be the Abid plant. Abid plant belongs to the company code 005 and the plant number is also 005. Let me go to the assignment first. In the assignment, materials management, sorry, it has to be assign plant to company code. Okay. Okay, I am going to use this company code 005, company code, and plant is 005. Why I chose 005? Because this also belongs to Germany plant, and mine also, that is the 1000 and 1200, also belongs to Germany. So that I won't be getting the problem of this material extension or your currency thing. So that is why I chose 005. Okay, so this is my first setting. Okay. And second setting is like this plan 005 must be extended to my sales organization. Extended in the assignment must be made. So what is my sales organization? It is 1000, reference plan is 10 and is 005. Okay, you could see that I have linked Abhi's plan with my sales organization so that I can make deliveries from this particular delivery plant. Then I talked about making myself as a customer to the Abhi's. Okay. So when I say like I want to make myself as a customer, how can I make myself as a customer? Which means like, do I have to create any customer master for myself, or if so, how I have to create? Okay. So for that, let us go to the sales and distribution billing. We come to intercompany billing. Okay. Here, the first thing you define for which order type channel you can use the billing document type. Okay. So OR. For OR, IV, that is intercompany billing, has been assigned before. Okay. Another assignment for you, go to the sales document type customizing, either through transaction for VO, V8 or through the this sales document header and document type. Okay. Inside the document type customizing, you can see the billing types for your intercompany. Other billing types you can see like order related billing F1, delivery related billing F2, and intercompany billing is IV. Okay, so that is the first one. Okay. And second one is the define internal customer. This is what I was talking about. When I say that I have to make myself as a customer to Abhi, I am saying, okay, mine is the, my sales organization is 1000, against which I have assigned a, created a dummy customer 10,000. Okay. So let me see what is there in the 10,000 slash O DD02. Okay. I select the customer sales order, which means I must have extended this to the company code of the plant with from which I am going to take the goods from. In our case, this is 005. Okay. So I have extended my this customer to the sales area of 005, 10 and 00. Okay. So let me select that, go inside. When if you go to the your regular customer like T-S62A01 or 02, you can see the account group like for which they have been created for. Okay. So let me go to extra administrative data. You could see these belongs to, these are not these are neither sold to party nor shipped to party, or your what you call as your bill to party or payment, it's nothing else. Instead it is created as a part plant. Okay. Customer belonging to group. Okay. I made the changes yesterday, which means I extended this to the this plant 005. That is why it is last change area is found here. Okay, against my name. And I have extended this customer, and this customer has been assigned to the, I mean I have created this customer and assigned it as a dummy customer against my sales organization. Okay. And I have assigned this customer to the sales area of my delivery instrument. Okay. In our role play, I have extended to the Abhi sales organization. And as usual, the quite logic is the logical step or logical sense is like the material which I am going to take from Abhi must be extended to the 005 plant. Okay. I have extended one material to handle this MM02 T-AT108. I didn't test 101 as 102 because that those are things I use regularly. Okay. So let me choose the general plant data and sales organization data because this has to be taken sold by maintained directly. So single plan system, plan data storage. So my plan is 0005. This plan belongs to both Abid organization as well as myself organization. Okay, so it is better to extend to both the places. You could see like the tax is maintained. So what is the tax connection from there? Okay, I mean that doesn't matter. I saw an empty field, so I just click it. So as usual, if you go to general plan, you can see this data is for the plan 005. Okay. Which means this article must be extended to the plan 005. As usual, you can see the plan 005 data, like what should be the weight, what should be your handling group, okay, your average price, moving price, and other things. Yes, you want to change. Then I have to make sure that there are enough stock of the material in the supplying plant. So I am using the transaction code MMBE2C2. P-AT108 in the plan 0005. Okay. Execute. Okay, how much is there? 300 is there as of now. Okay. But how much is there in my plan? That is 1200. Okay, 10,000. So we have done all of our basic settings. Now I am going to create a sales order for us. Sorry, it must be 1010. Okay. This is my intercompany sales. Okay. I gave a wrong sales area in the previous thing. So, let me choose the appropriate sales area. My article is P-AT108. Okay. Let me order 250 pieces, okay. And I am making the delivering plant as 0005, not my 1200. Obviously, even if I don't enter here as of now, okay, let me keep it. Okay, that is only problem. Mandatory condition CR00 is missing. Okay, yes, this CR00, it is. As usual, 395 euro. Okay, fine. PA01 is the intercompany price. For example, okay, when we are selling to a customer, external customer, or I am selling to my customer, external customer, I charge 395. Okay, but whenever we are exchanging goods among ourselves, okay, between ourselves, I say like, okay, let me leave off some margin, my some margin, okay. So we will take, okay, you give me for 350 or I will give you for 350. Okay, so let me maintain. That is the intercompany price. The condition, standard condition price for that is PI01. Okay. It's okay. Okay, but what is being taken for your customer is your standard PR00. Okay, so let me save it. It is going to say that there is something incomplete. This derivation rule said some COPA entry is missing, some derivation rule or something. Okay. So now I have created a delivery and I have created the sales order and replaced the plant with 005 after Abid has agreed to give the 250 units on behalf of me. Okay. Now instead of burdening Abid to create delivery, I am going to create delivery. Slash N. The hey, before that I have to see what is the shipping point. I forgot about that. VA02K11881. Okay, so let me go to the item details. My shipping point is 1000. Okay, so and scheduled for 6th of September. So let me create a delivery class in VL01N. Okay. My shipping point is 1000. it is 05092011 and this is going to be the okay. Let me check the okay. It is not at pegged because like you cannot create a transfer order for your customer, I mean for your delivering plan. Okay. So let me manually enter the picked quantity. Okay. It changes to fully picked and I carry out here post goods issue. Okay, the delivery has been changed. Now let me bill for this delivery. AM01. Let me copy the tag. Okay, this is my so what happened? Error launch. I don't know why I enabled the POD for this customer. Cash and email POD. Okay. There we go. POD. Save this customer. Now let me carry out here. ES01. That is billing. Okay. The first bill I write, it is for the our customer. Can you see the payer is P-6801? Okay. What is the pricing error made? I mean, there is some error related with our this thing, the derivation rule. Okay. And PI01 is missing. So, PI01, what we agreed to, it was 350 euros per piece. Okay. Okay. So, this invoice is raised against my customer. Okay. This is what I am going to send for my customer. Okay. Now, using the same delivery, okay, I am writing the second invoice. Okay. Now this time I am the payer. Can you see the payer is so and so? Okay. And there is a pricing error between PI01 is missing. Okay. Go there. PI01 350. Okay. Now can you see the price changes to your previously it was something around 98,750. Now after you have entered the PI00, PR00 gets deactivated. That is why this symbol becomes an yellow triangle, okay, which means inactive price. PR00 gets inactivated and PA00 gets the prominence or dominance. Okay, it comes back. Okay, now you save it. So successfully you have, okay, there is some issue with the accounting documents and what is the problem. Let me check whether this is not really fit for control C. So this is our famous intercompany sales scenario. Okay, let me try to release to accounting. Company code customer 1000 is not different than the company code. Okay, maintain the customer master record. Okay, I had extended the sales area only. Okay. So I must have extended the company code data also. Okay, no problem. So like at least we are able to create the billing document. So this is the famous intercompany sales process. Okay. Intercompany sales will really make you to scratch your head and find out like why you would certain things didn't go in the way you expected or something. Okay. But once you understood that logic, I mean like once you start putting down the process in sequence or steps, so you will be able to find out. Okay. So what are the logic steps first? Okay. We have to find out from which company code our supplying plan belongs to. Okay. Then we have to add that plant into our distribution chain, that is the our sales organization distribution channel combination. Okay. Then we have to maintain the material in both the delivering plant as well as our plant. Okay. Then we have to create ourselves as a customer so that we will be our delivering plant will be sending invoice to us for the goods we had taken from them. Okay. So only when we are a customer we will be receiving the invoice. Okay. So we create a customer with the account group PLNT and assign it against the sales organization. Then what is it? We maintain the material in the general time data for the delivering plant and the material combination. Then what we did, obviously we maintain the stock in the delivering plant. Okay. Now these are the configuration part. Okay. Then obviously we have to assign the intercompany billing for the order type. Okay. For our order type, the standard intercompany billing type is IB. Okay. Then the company billing is ECM. Okay. So when we came to the execution part, that is the EC access or end user activity, business activity, what we did, we created a change order. Instead of the default delivering plan proposed by the system, we had overwritten it with the our actual delivering plan that belongs to other company scope. Okay. One main point, intercompany sales carries, intercompany sales is only for only active when the delivering plan belongs to other company core. That is the first and foremost thing. Okay. If the delivering plan is also belonging to your company core, but then it won't be of then it won't be of that much. Then it becomes a normal sale. Okay. So the delivering plant must belong to different company for that is the main part here. Okay. So you create a sales order in the delivering plant, you override the default supposed delivering plant with the new delivering plant that belongs to other company code. Okay. Then you save it, as usual you create a delivery, process the delivery, do the goods issue. Okay. Then you write the invoice. In first, the first time you write the invoice against your customer with your normal sales price, and second time when you write the invoice is right against you, okay, from the company code of the delivering plant. Okay. So this is the intercompany sales. Okay. It may look confusing, of course, like when you try to do it for your own materials and your own sales organization, it will definitely make you to scratch your head. Don't worry about that, but at the end of the day, when you are able to carry out this session, you will be very happy. Okay, so we will catch up tomorrow morning, and tomorrow you will see the rebate as well as the contract. Okay, I hope you will be understanding. Unfortunately, this is not a part of the standard Siemens or SAP material. Okay, so I will try to find out whether I can find any assignments for this. Okay, we will catch up tomorrow morning. Have a good day.